Hey guys, Brycen with Trick Tools here. We're gonna welcome you guys back for Trick Tip Tuesday. Today, I'm gonna be talking about once you've got bend lines marked out in a piece, how the location of where you place those in a break can change the width of where your flange is. So, marked both of these pieces out to, they were 3 inches wide, had an inch and a half section in the middle. We're gonna be bending those up and how the placement on there changed the width. As you can see, one fits inside the other. So we'll explain that and we'll come back to you. All right, so in order to get your measurements where you want them, as far as your bend lines, if you're looking for inch and a half, say inside to inside, once you break these flanges, or inch and a half outside to outside, is gonna depend on where you place it in the break. So I've got both of these pieces marked at inch and a half wide for my bend lines here. So on the first piece, I'm gonna use the actual bend location on the break. So down in this corner, right where the pieces meet here and that thing bends, I'm gonna bend right on that line. And then I will change on this other piece to bend right on the edge of the fingers here, and that'll change the width of the pieces. So if I line this up here, right on this bend line on the break, clamp it in, break that over. The way the break is set up, the way I always set it up, is based on whatever material thickness I'm bending. So this is 063 aluminum, so I've got that 063 gap between the edge of the bar, the fingers here, and the break here. That way, when this gets bent, it's not actually smashing the metal between the edge of the fingers and the break. So got that side bent, flip it over, line it back up with the bend line on the break itself. Clamp that in. Bend that over, and now what that's done, by lining it up there, it's actually bent this a little narrower on the inside because of the placement. So I've got my inch and a half outside to outside measurement that I was wanting. So on the second piece, I'm gonna line up my bend lines that I marked out on the edge of the fingers here. So bring the break down, line it up with the edge of the fingers, clamp it in. Got that bent, flip it over. Line the second side up with the edge of the fingers. Bend it. Now what that's done is it's by lining my lines up with the edge of the fingers here, it's ensured that the inside measurement is going to remain at the inch and a half where I wanted it. So I've got my inch and a half here, right on my bend lines, and the outside measurement is right around 1 5/8". So yeah, that's basically how, using a break, you can have your bend lines in the same location marked out on your piece, but where you locate them on the break will determine whether it's going to be inch and a half inside or inch and a half outside measurement. So well, I hope you guys learned something on this Trick Tip Tuesday, and hopefully this little lesson on a finger break can help you when you're trying to get a certain width on a part, whether you want outside width or inside width, and go from there. So, like I said, I hope you guys enjoyed this, and we'll see you next Tuesday.